Welcome back, folks. We are here at the SSE Arena, the Wembley area of London, England. We are getting ready to go into match two. Obviously, we saw that first matchup with Fallen and Gang winning over Ninjas in Pajamas. They will take on the winner of our next match, and then Ninjas in Pajamas is going to take on the loser of the next match. Again, still working on Group A here, and it's going to be G2, number six ranked by Half-Life TV. And I did misspoke in the intro. Literally days ago, Liquid was number 10. So I had that idea of like six out of eight top 10, but they have recently dropped down to 14 after the last event. So they are 14th, G2 is six. Initial thoughts on the matchup.
I think it's hard to rate Liquid right now, to be fair, because they just brought JDM in from CLG and Simple is playing as a stand-in for them at this tournament. So they are a big question mark as in what kind of a performance are we going to see from them.
All right, and we've got G2 right in front of us. Let's just jump right into it. Let's do the roster rundown of G2. Why don't you take us through this, Robin?
Yeah, I mean, this is the core four that's been around the same team for a while. It's actually the guy to the left, the bodyy, who is the replacement of Existence, their former in-game leader. Now you have the shox taking over that reign. But yeah, some very old school players here. Shox and Smith have been playing together for a very long time. You have Scream, obviously the one taps, and RpK, former CS Source legend. Started playing CSGO in the beginning, but then ended up retiring for a while, for a little bit over a year, I think, and then he got brought back into the same squad.
Yeah, and again, they're doing quite well, especially that duo, Shox and Scream. When they're on point, they're on point, especially when Shox fires up. Like, he can literally almost single-handedly kill anybody.
I mean, he's had some insane performances, especially in the ECS, him and Scream. Shox basically, you know, opening bomb sites by himself, and when he's playing that well, there's really not a lot you can do. It's a bit unfair to the other teams. But again, that's the talking point here. That's based off of individual performance. It's not like G2 is having these insane levels of team play or some crazy strats. They're basically feeding off of performances from mainly Shox and then Scream as well in most of their games. So it's something that it's hard to be consistent at that sort of a playstyle. Fnatic is probably the only team in the world that managed to do it.
And on the other side of the coin, obviously we've talked about it a little bit, Liquid, new roster, and a stand-in and Simple. He is back, but he is back temporarily. Pimp will be joining the roster officially later. And then JDM is a true new ad coming over from CLG. Why don't you walk us through these guys?
Yeah, I mean, they had the biggest performance with Simple in the lineup at MLG, where they made it all the way to the semifinals, top four. But here it is going to be, I think, up to their individual performances as well, right? They cannot have that some crazy level of team play. I think it's mostly going to revolve around Simple and JDM, probably. It's going to be interesting to see. I presume that JDM is going to be the main operator, especially because he is not very proficient with rifles, even in his time as in CLG. So I expect him to be the main opper, Simple to be the guy taking point with the rifle, perhaps. So as I said, it's going to be a big question mark how they decide to come into this one. We see that they had a lot of confidence on social media, saying that the boot camp went fairly well, that they're feeling pretty confident coming into this one. So we'll have to wait and see.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the stack of this team, this should be on paper the best team in North America. JDM, CLG's best player. You were talking about the former CLG roster where it's supposed to be Tarik, and then JDM just somewhat stepped up to be their star player. At least for me, it's like one of the most consistent players in that North American scene. Rarely has a bad game, always steps up when he needs to. Nitro is supposed to be, if you just look at the team before these two latest auditions, Nitro was supposed to be their superstar player coming in and just be that mad fragger, that little entry kind of role, but it never really turned out that way. He does have some good games, and obviously he does have some bad games. But the one guy to go to here for Liquid is obviously Hiko, Clutchmaster, been around the scene for a very long time. Also one of the best players in North America, and he also again rarely has a bad game. And he's the guy that you're going to be looking into to closeout games, right? If it's a closeout game, you expect Hiko to be the kind of the point guard to just be able to win those clutch situations and just end up winning. And then, yeah, sure, Simple. Did not have a good showing at the major. Yeah, as Janko was saying, it was with Simple. They made it through that whole run, but it wasn't really Simple that was stepping up. So it's going to be fun to see here now if, depending on the how the structure is, because he's only a stand-in. You have JDM, he's supposed to be the primary opper. Maybe he will pick up the AWP a little bit, maybe depending on the map. But I expect him to just be solely on the rifle.
And I wonder, in Simple, we're going to bring in the players of the game. It's going to be Simple and Shox. And I wonder, in Simple's case, you know, when he was full-time Liquid, he wasn't really happy living in North America. He had a lot of issues. He was homesick, all those things. He's a young guy. And now he's just coming in as a hired gun. So you wonder if all that pressure, all that, like, angst of, like, maybe not wanting to be on the team as a permanent member has all gone away and he can just, like, do his thing, you know?
I think he did that anyways in Liquid.
Well, okay,
you know, he basically did what he wanted. Just to make it clear for the viewers, the reason Simple doesn't have any stats is because he didn't play in the online part of the league here on the
No, he just never got a frag already.
Those stats are just for the
obvious,
league.
Never know. And I think that you see these two players here, and Shox is also the in-game leader of the team. So in a sense that being the star player and the in-game leader, he puts himself in positions to create space for his team, right? Whether if it's on Dust 2, he goes down suicide really fast, gets cat control, and then depending on what he sees on the way and you know what the way he reads the game, he gives calls to his teammates. And most of the time, G2 just goes for these simple setups on the T side, utilizing the most common setups for the CTs and finding a way to work around it.
And the maps, just so you know, last couple of months, 3 months or so, these two teams have not met at all. So there's no head-to-head to even talk about, regardless of the roster changes. And on top of that, the teams that always... Liquid right now has always banned Inferno. Doesn't matter anymore because now Nuke has replaced Inferno in the active pool for ECS as well as the game. And then G2 basically the last 3 months has never played Mirage. So that's probably going to be one of their first bans. But let's get that started and I'll have you guys walk us through that.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's going to be really hard to tell here what Liquid might end up wanting to play. I mean, the one that always comes to mind is always, you know, a map like Dust 2, a very open map. So you utilize the mad fragments that you have within the team. But they have been boot camping. They are saying that they have been looking really good so far. So we might actually see a little bit of a gamble here. You do see the Mirage ban coming in from G2, like you're talking about. But yeah, Overpass coming from Liquid.
I have a feeling it's going to be Cobblestone.
Cobblestone, okay. Okay.
I mean, I agree with Robin. There's a number of maps they can go for. It also depends with this new lineup. Maybe Liquid wants to change their map pool as well, right? Maybe they will start picking up some of the newer maps, and you can't really predict what they like to play. So I think that for G2, it's going to be, we would like to play our strongest maps, and we'll see if we can get to one of those if possible.
And there goes Train. And again, a reminder for folks at home, there is no pick phase. It's all bans. Each team gets 3 bans, and then they do a coin flip at the beginning. If you win the coin flip, you get to decide if you want to be the first banner or if you want to defer that and have that last ban.
I definitely expect Liquid to ban Nuke at some point because we saw the G2 is willing to play it. I don't think that Liquid, with the limited amount of time they had, that they spent time on that map in particular, they go for a cash ban. This is where I was, you know, it was... interesting to me to see if they're going to ban Cash. It's a map they played that they've been really good on, or are they going to veto Dust 2 because it's G2's strongest map? But we see that G2 actually goes for it, and now it's between Nuke and Cobble.
Yeah, and Liquid were smart here as well, as Janko. Yeah,
okay.
As Janko was saying, I mean, it makes a lot of sense. Liquid having that last pick, and then just leaving Nuke in the map because they can always pick it. You know, they ban the ones that they really don't want to play, and just leaving Nuke in the map pool to see if maybe G2 wants to spend a veto on it. But instead, exactly what Janko was saying, Cobble. I think it's. Even with the former Liquid roster, even in CLG, it's a map that. Actually, more so for Liquid. It's a map that they actually did like to play before, and then also coming from G2, it's not a bad map for them.
Yeah, and G2's got a 75% win ratio on it for the last 3 months. They're 6-2 on it. And again, I know Liquid's roster's changed. They are 9-4 with a 69% win rate. So not necessarily a deal breaker for either one in that sense.
Yeah, it is one of their most, I think for G2 it's Dust 2, and then it's also Train, Cash, Cobble, depending on their opponents. Most of the time, I am a bit surprised they veto Dust 2, but I guess it's because Liquid is kind of a mixed team and it's really easy to play Dust 2, even if you are a mixed team with a lot of talent and great toppers on their team. So Cobble, I would give the G2 the upper hand here because you do need more teamwork and more structure to be able to execute on as both T and CT.
So you're going to take G2 Cobble, and you're going to...
I really don't want to take a gamble here.
Come on, do it.
Yeah, the thing is, since we don't really know anything that much about Liquid at this current
state... You live
state,
in North America now. Come on.
Yeah, but they've been in Europe. With the lineup, right? And I think that I have a feeling that if Shox doesn't show up here, then Liquid could actually win this. Now it is Cobblestone, and it's G2 is very good on the map.
Have you been with Liquid in their boot camp?
No, like, I have not.
Have you been with them in Amsterdam, Robin? Have you been smoking some of that funny stuff?
I know how North Americans normally do. Like they're like, yeah, we did well in practice. We didn't lose a single game. Come to an official game, and just get crashed, right? So I think I'm gonna play it safer. I'm gonna go with G2 as well, but I think gonna be close.
Raising all the hype, like, oh yeah, Liquid, and just saying, oh yeah,
I can still change my mind if you want. I'm just saying. I still stick by to the same thing though. If Shox doesn't show up, I think Liquid could win.
So there's a chance, but you're just gonna give it to G2 no matter what.
Yeah, but yeah. It is a pretty volatile matchup in a sense that they're dependent on individual performances to an extent. But even without that, I feel that G2 as a team has what it takes to beat Liquid here.
All right, thank you, gentlemen. The players are ready, our casters are ready, and once again, it's gonna be Dan and James. James, why don't you talk first after all?
No, it's Dan's turn now.
Ah, see how you are? You kill me. You kill me over there.
All right, Cobblers, Liquid starting on the T side. Simples, good to see him back in action, even if it's for a short period of time. And let's not forget JDM, the new boy here for Liquid as well. There is a man in waiting, but all eyes on Liquid for this one, I think.
Yeah, I wonder with Simple if the fact that there's no pressure really on him because he's standing in, whether that's going to allow him to just go even more ham. Let's see. Obviously, we have the pistol round playing out. Now we've got four players for G2 moving towards the B-bomb side to start things off here at the moment. And very defensive kind of retake-esque play going towards A, with just one man just watching for G2 as to what's going on. And Liquid, they're just holding on for now. Just chilling.
Chilling out.
And waiting for something to be happening at the moment because there's no reason for them to push. It's hard to push in this map. It's very dangerous. You kind of just have to wait as the CT side. And Liquid, they're taking their time, but slowly but surely they start to now gain positioning towards A long, which is something. It does look like they want to go towards A.
You can see Shox looking for some info here. And that's going to start the rotation here for the CTs over towards the A bomb site. They might get in position in time there. We've got a fight for the site coming in as well while the Shox gets taken down by Hiko. Indeed, EliGE is going to take RpK up towards the high ground there, but the bomb might not get planted because there's nothing but headshots coming in from Scream and Smiths. Hiko alone now. They know where he was, so he's going to have a hard time of this. Sees Smiths, though, heavily tagged on the roof. Can't take him down yet. Just looking for trying to get himself some one versus ones, trying to figure out where all the players are. He knows where two are now, roughly. And he resets the situation. Finally, Smiths goes down. Five bullets in the magazine here for Hiko. And he's got two almost full health players to find. Just trying to suggest with that jump that he's gone one way when he indeed goes the other. He's only got 15 seconds to play with that. Does he even realize this? He's got to run for it now. Put out of his misery by Scream.
Yep, nice headshots by Scream. Three there for him, as you would expect. The headshot machine is delivering said headshots. And G2 can start things off well. And it's going to be, it's always cool to see G2 playing because their structure, the way the team is set up, is that their individual players, like Scream and Shox, they have to go off for G2 to play well. And that's just how it works. It's just that's the bottom line of how the team is at the moment. So that's going to be interesting to see going into this one. We've got Liquid now deciding to go for a fast play towards that B-bomb. So they got a bunch of smokes, a bunch of Tech Nines, and some Kevlars to boot. Although it looks like some counter grenades are going to make their lives a little bit more tricky, so they're going to have to slow it down just ever so slightly. You can see Hiko is lining up a smoke grenade, waiting for some of those counter smokes from the CT side to dissipate before they run through, as they have no idea what's going on behind that smoke. And G2, again, just holding, but they've only got three players here. This could actually work for Liquid as they start to toss in the nades now. And it's, oh dear.
Oh dear.
Bit of a failure there.
That's not good. That is a problem because they've smoked themselves off from the site, Dan. That is a bit of a disaster. Body's got a great position with the new update to Cobble to punish them for that smoke. That is a massive disaster. The counterpatch is coming in as well. Liquid are in a traffic jam and they're getting taken down by the monster truck here. Only one player lost. That's Body. Takes two with him as well. So a great round by G2 and a completely disastrous round for Liquid.
Yep, definitely not how they wanted things to go. And now they are down to the eco, full eco for them. leading into the next round, where you can see JDM is saving for an AWP, and Simple is going to take his perch at the Deagle. This is very, very classic Simple style, just always getting the Deagle in there no matter what. And you see it more often these days as players generally get better with it, but his aim is raw aim is so insane that he tends to be quite consistent. We'll have to see if RpK can be consistent here. There's the UMP spraying away, and it's Hiko with the frag, only after one from RpK. Which is a little bit scary. Now Shox steps up to the plate with his UMP. He's going to find himself one bit of help from Body there as well. There is the Deagle frag from Simple, and there is another one. And that is why Simple picks it up. Well, three players dead. G2 move into the next round. But they've got an AWP to deal with now.
Yeah, and it is on JDM. There aren't that many grenades on Liquid. Maybe that's a good thing, Dan, if they are unable to throw them over walls and smoke themselves off from sights. AWP onto Smith's as well. We will see where these two gentlemen choose to go. Smith's going over towards A long for the time being. And indeed, it seems they're going to have the forces on Liquid over towards the A bomb site with a lurker towards B, but there might be a fast boost coming in there, so maybe G2 have a read onto the way that Liquid are choosing to play here, because I don't know that there are any nades there. Simple getting taken down straight away as well, so Liquid need to move fast here, and it seems that they are.
Yeah, but it was already a man down. Things get a little bit more tricky, but there is the entry frag. That's what Nitro is there to do, and the bomb site will be claimed by Liquid as RpK tries to find a way in. He's got a crowbar, but can he wedge himself an opening? Looks like not just yet. Nitro's close to the doors. I mean, this is just so impossible. Shox has to do something with this flank to create space for G2 to get in.
There is a kit on screen, so it's a bit of time, but the numbers are running down pretty quickly. EliGE, Nitro with two frags. There are tagged players here. That was one of them, Hiko. And Nitro's running for his life now. Could be going for a flank of his own. EliGE getting taken down now, and there's still time on the clock here for the CT to do it, but Shox is the one close to the site, and Scream's one of the kit. Scream getting a headshot onto JDM now, but again, it's Scream who needs to defuse the bomb. Shox has got to be the meat shield, but where is Nitro coming in from the site? And there it is. Shox can pick up the kit, but I don't think he's got time. I don't think he's got time to do it. No, nice retake attempt there by G2, but just not fast enough. Another round goes to Liquid.
It's that duo again, isn't it? Shox and Scream, if they're alive, you have problems, no matter what the situation is. That's quite fun. Now we've got the 3-1. Liquid just need to string rounds together. G2, they don't actually have much to stop this, having received so much damage in the previous round. So that said, Liquid themselves, they don't have the best buy in the world. A couple of Galils in the mix, limited utility. Let's see what strategy they opt to go for, because they should realize that G2 are hurting as well. Oh, Smith's playing a dangerous game here with that CZ, but it's a good position whilst the smoke is up. Boost here from Shox as well, early in the round. Get some information, maybe a sneaky frag as well. Although he has received some damage, I can only imagine it was from an HE.
No Molotovs to force G2 from their positions anywhere on the map. That is a nice reverse boost there coming in from Liquid. Very nice indeed. Much safer way to check things there. And that's a nasty surprise for Shox. Got his bell rung and then some. So an early advantage here for Liquid with just over a minute on the clock here. Two players per site at the moment. And G2 don't really have a lot of information. So it's going to be a slow rotation from the A site because they are so deep in that direction. Scream trying to stop a split from coming in by putting down that smoke, but Liquid are not going to react just yet. They've got a player in the drop, and once these smokes disappear, then G2 may have a difficult hold on their hands.
Yeah, it's starting to boil over this presence towards the B bomb site. Start to move in now. Screens behind the boulder. There's quick trade of frags. More to be had here for Simple and EliGE as they completely destroy this B bomb site defense from G2. We got Smith coming in with the CZ, and I mean, there are a few low players here, so there's potential to do something, but his positioning is not going to really give him the best engagements against these rifles. So it's going to be very hard. Now he's been spotted as well. The element of surprise is no longer an element, but he's going to actually pick off the most healthy player there with the CZ. Nice little burst there with the two bullets. JDM is now dead. Will Smith opt to run with the AK? Looks like that is definitely a good choice, and he's going to go for it. So AK into the next round here for G2, but they will lose it, and his teammates will have no money, as well as will he. Although he'll save his Kevlar. So Liquid wing that second round in a row that they need to.
Alrighty then. Let's see what the money situation is like. Nobody really has the money to spend on any Kevlar on the CT side, so I would expect that Smith should be continuing with the AK here. Wouldn't be worth the aim punch for Shox to take it, or similar, RPK, etc., Scream, anyone on the team. So here we go. Hiko and his boys continuing their run. Got an M4, two M4s, two AKs, and the UMP onto JDM. We're looking to just build yet some more money for the rounds to come. So we'll see if Liquid can continue their success. And again, this round is, well, it should be all about Smiths, but of course you see Scream playing the close quarters corners there, looking to get the one tap. And Smiths is going to get taken down by a Simple. Over towards the B bomb site. That's going to cause a one-man rotation. We'll see how Liquid choose to continue the rest of their anti-eco here.
Yeah, I mean, they've already got that first kill, so it just gets easier from here, potentially. But we can see a stack of players towards the A-long area there for G2. Looks like Liquid will circumvent it somewhat as they move away and towards that B bomb site instead. It's just Nitro has been left in the vicinity, covering the flank as Liquid approach towards B. And you can see the bomb site is actually empty right now, which is great news for Liquid moving forwards. They have the information player Hiko on the bomb site. He's going to find out all that juicy information, that it is indeed clear and the bomb can be planted without resistance. Nice, very, very nice, very fast frag indeed onto Shox. And the cleanup operation begins. So, pretty straightforward round from Liquid. It looks like they're not going to lose a man, which is definitely exactly what you want to do in a round like this. There you go, Nitro. He's actually picking up a lot of frags so far. And I mean, if Nitro is able to deliver, that really is great for Liquid, because as already was mentioned, he tends to be that dynamic rifler, the entry fragger. That's the sort of role that he's playing. And when your entry fragger's on, you're having a good time.
All right, so JDM on a rare rifle, continuing. No reason to pick up an AWP just yet, although he doesn't have the money to do it. Some of his team do, but indeed they are playing the passive route right now. And I like not buying the AWP when you know that the other team are going to be on an eco or a force fire as well, because it gives your allows the team to be more dynamic in a situation where you might need to, due to a stack of a sight or a multi-man push in an unlikely area, and so on and so forth. We've got Scream playing around the smoke here and the box with the Mag 7, looking for someone to overextend. But Liquid are one of the more disciplined teams in that regard. They can be, they can show a lot of patience in rounds. And G2 forced to bide their time over towards the B bomb site. There are three players over towards A long here for the CT, so you do wonder if they will push a little bit more forward, try and find out some info. You have the early pressure here from Liquid over towards the B site, maybe trying to bait somebody to engage them, but they may not like it when they do, as there we go, the Mag 7 coming in there for Scream. One meat shot there for JDM, and Nitro taking down from the back.
Yeah, but we still have a deal here on Shox. As you can see, that is could be a very big first kill, second frag, and a third from Body. Oh my goodness, four kills just like that with the deagles there. Body and Shox with bullets for days. And that's going to be a 4-3 answer as G2 propel themselves back into economic superiority. Although that said, it's not really that superior. It's very marginally superior, to be honest, with the RPK having 4,500 in the bank. But that is pretty nice, and they're going to invest into AWP. So they're spending the bucks, the big bucks here.
Three orbs on the map. JDM finally picking one up, courtesy of Nitro. And now they've got a second person pursuing the B bomb site now. Maybe because of those earlier boosts here from G2, they're going to give it some more attention than previous. So G2 playing passive for the time being, two people over towards A. Again, they're focusing on a support play towards the beginning of the long area from the site, over towards A. Meanwhile, over towards B, you've got one on the site itself. Now moving in for a bit of harassment of the crack in the wall. And one over towards the chicken coop. And we still see a lot of different holds in the drop zone. This is one of them that is a bit of a blind spot. Or it's at least very awkward to check that position, especially when there are many other places you can get shot from in that immediate area. But yeah, I mean, the drop gets held differently by many different teams. Often from outside of it, sometimes with repeated peaks, maybe with two people and so on. And it seems we might have an NIP-esque execute, at least with nades over towards B.
Yeah, they've got just enough grenades to get a set piece going onto the B-bomb site, and that's what they're going to do. And they're actually going to take the bomb towards the A-bomb site. So this is going to be a fake here, where they try to split one player down, drop towards A, and hey, if you're going to get a custom kills here on the push from the fake, that's how it's going to be going well for you every single time. We've got a lot of harassment here from Hiko and Connector. Simple still doing damage there on the B bomb side as the push with the bomb comes into the A site. This looks pretty easy here. Great execution of this fake from Liquid. The bomb goes down just in the nick of time as Scream finds himself 1v4. And let's not forget, they just won a round and now they're going to get completely cleaned up. So that is brutal. A couple players left with some cash here for G2, but three left in, well, in poverty.
Yeah, good start so far for Liquid. 4 from 8. And indeed, it is G2 in financial turmoil at the moment. So this is a great opportunity for Liquid to extend their lead somewhat. RPK has got 5k in the bank, so he can pick up Deagle and drop it to a teammate if he wanted to. In fact, most of his team have bought some pistols up, Smith, though, just with the USB. So maybe with 4950, he can drop his teammate Deagle, or maybe he'll drop an all for him in the following round. So far, so good for JDM. Punishes Smith for overextending towards the long A area. The bomb is elsewhere, though, so G2 won't have much information on that at present. And that will leave two over towards A long and two over towards B, trying to support each other as much as possible. Simple though, gets his bell rung, but he has other ideas as to who will be ringing what bells. B bomb site has now been cleared.
And it does seem kind of like Liquid are definitely playing a lot better at the moment. It's just that G2 factor that they can just win any round because of the skill that they have on the team. But you can see here again, you know, that consistency from Liquid, you know, coming out to play here, just bringing in the anti-eco, executing it tightly enough that they have a 4v2 situation here with the bomb down. And AK could be saved by RPK, and it very well, or very likely will be, but that won't amount to too much. And in the near future, I don't think Liquid are too worried about that. They just want to maintain the integrity of their own economy. As you can see, they safely move together, you know, watching for any spots that the AK could be hiding in to actually damage their economy, but G2 have, you know, instead opted to save it. So moving into a 5-4 situation, I'm curious, you know, how well, how many rounds G2 are going to get on the CT side, actually, because their T side is very scary, so four to five rounds might be enough for them.
Time will tell. It must be hard for G2 to prepare against Liquid in this situation, especially with JDM being a new boy on and Simple being a stand-in here. It's like, how do you try and anti-strat that kind of situation? It must be quite difficult. I think we'll see if Cobblestone proves to be one of Liquid's stronger maps in this vacuum with Simple as a temporary stand-in. So far, so good, though. 5-4 lead here against G2. G2, again, going to concentrate on the long A area with three over towards the B-bomb site. And again, there are a few people holding, but we'll see if they're willing to continue their aggression over there. Meanwhile, Simple's going to be the lurker. More traditional approach there that we used to see that from Cobblestone, like, kind of 6 months ago, perhaps. Just somebody going over towards the B-bomb site with constant harassment towards the plateau. But he has friends in tow. You have an AWP holding the angle there. That smoke will allow that to happen more often as well.
So they're getting ready now. Problem is, these nades just slowing it down. It's very frustrating, but there's ways to circumvent that as well. Little boost there onto RPK. This allows also RPK to, you know, if G2 would like to, they just leave RPK there because he can be fairly safe in that position from attacks from both sides. Although exposed particularly well to one. But here it is. This is what Liquid were playing for, getting that drop control. They got JDM in there, looking for that opening pick to really set the pace in. They do need something at this point because They are running out of time. There's 40 seconds left on the clock as JD looks for this shot. And there might be a peek in store, but no. No peeks just yet for JDM. But his team still have to go.
30 seconds of the clock there. That's a very nice opening onto screen. Body soon to follow as well. And we've got shox trying to do what he can, but it's just a one frag vim. So 3-for-1. That is a strong round for Liquid so far. And the remaining CTs have to try and hold on to what they have. RpK and Smiths over towards A, wondering what is happening to their fallen comrades, or rather, what has happened. So another round is looking likely to be in the bag here for Liquid. How far will their momentum take them?
Yeah, another nicely constructed run. And you can see, even though they didn't get the pick that they were really looking for early into the rounds, they were still able to say, you know, have that plan B behind it, literally, as they decided to take control over drop and slowly push JDM there. They, you know, unlike a lot of teams that are very, sometimes they can be very, hesitant to push unless they get that condition, which is, we really need this pick. We're going to wait until there's 20 seconds left, and then they'll go. Liquid realize, okay, by the time there's 35, 40 seconds left, we need to do something regardless of what, you know, what our initial plan was. If that doesn't work out, we have this other thing to go to, and they executed it pretty well. And if you consider the fact that they haven't had much practice together with this lineup, with two new players, that is somewhat impressive. So let's see how long they can keep that going, because the AWP has been saved here by Smiths, and it's always going to be danger in that situation.
All right, so we have a change in approach here from G2, although they are on a semi-eco here. Again, this tree position, when you see grenade executes into the B bomb site, it used to get molotoved quite a lot. I've seen a lack of Molotovs in this position recently. I'm not sure why, because it's very strong for the CT, so maybe it's down to a lack of utility on the Ts in those executes, or maybe it's something else. Either way, but just always keep an eye on that position on Cobblestone, because it tends to be a very important one for the counter-terrorists, and if they're not forced from their position there, it can be a determining factor in some rounds. So just running to his death there through the scope of Smiths, that was very unfortunate for him. So a nice advantage for Liquid, minutes on the clock here. And G2 don't really have any idea as to where Liquid are going. A Liquid who've moved into the drop zone and have a potential to split now. Body's in a lot of trouble here, Dan.
Yeah, he's dead now. And the bombsite goes to Liquid without too much issue. And again, it's another round where they just clean up the map. They get the information. They slowly get the execution in there. They're just looking pretty solid at the moment. And that's going to be another round for them, although their money's starting to grow to this degree that they really should try to find a way to eliminate one of the orbs that's left. Obviously, it's going to be very hard, because you can see the Smiths can take these very long channels to defend from with that orb, and so it's hard to like find a way to approach that. I mean, obviously, you have to use grenades. There's not really any left on Liquid. A couple smokes, about it. That's about it. You need some flashbangs, to be honest. So Liquid might eventually end up getting there, but there, that's exactly what I was talking about. So hard to approach Smiths from that angle. Kind of need to get in from where RpK is, and that's not going to happen here. So it's G2 looking like they're going to hold on to two big guns, a lot of nades, Kit, and a Kevlar on screen there, as well as the Deagle. So G2 actually doing really well to save there. That's going to help them massively. If they lose this round, they can spend a lot of money this round. If they lose this one, they should actually be able to buy straight away again with a decent buy with the money that they've saved.
So, AWP onto both sides now. Loads of utility onto both teams as well. It's a very good opportunity for G2 to put a hole in his leak. Now they've got four people going over towards the B bomb site, do the CTs, and they're leaving Smiths alone. He has a nice angle though. Oh, he's gonna look away just as Nitro comes into the reticle there. So he's got some information for his team. Now the question is, are Liquid willing to move fast with this info that they have as well?
It's like they are willing to be quite fast indeed. We've got a lot of players here. The response is strong as well. It's just going to be a slugfest, but a very fast one of that as two frags go straight towards Liquid. It's shox to answer back with only a single kill. That's not going to be good enough. Body tries to step up here, and he will. Two frags from him. Scream chimes in as well. And now it's a 2-1 in favor of G2. They've somehow managed to turn this one all the way around. And now Hiko has not only to kill a couple players here, but he's got to plant this bomb still. These nades will provide him some cover to do so, and he will get the bomb planted, but there's still a lot of work to do.
2-1. Tons of time on the clock, and Body's got a kit. We see some initial nades coming in. That's going to force Hiko from his position, and that will allow G2 to make it through the choke point. Scream going to get his, going to ring Hiko's bell and get a follow-up kill as well. So that is a round on the board for G2. They've indeed stopped the momentum, at least for now here, for the Liquid side. We'll have to see how much money both teams have, as the CT's only survived with two players, so that's going to be expensive for them as well. Almost every player on Liquid is in five figures there, over 10k. So they'll have no issue buying up in this round for the most part. The AWP will continue on to Smiths in the meantime. And they'll get a lot of nades out, actually, the G2 side, which is an improvement on previous rounds.
Yeah, and, well, I mean, right now, this matchup seems pretty up in the air. And that's really cool to see between these two teams, especially Liquid, such an unknown factor. Good to see that they're making this very competitive. And right now we've got Simple going for the simple plays, charging up the plateau, looking for a quick pick there. Lots of players to be found from all angles. Three guys on his position. He somehow actually gets a frag out of that, which is kind of crazy, to be honest. But what can his team get out of this? It's a 4v4. It's often going to favor the terrorist side, especially on a map like this, where there's a lot to cover and too few players to cover it with. There's the CTs, and in goes Liquid towards A.
Molotov to force Smith from his position, but first he's going to see the bomb and get a frag. EliGE completely blind, gets taken down. Smith can't see what he's doing, but he gets killed anyway. Hiko over towards the bomb site now. A bomb site trying to contain the players. The bomb's being collected by JDM. There's still a minute on the clock here, so Hiko has some work to do. Two players on the site looking for the trade fragger rotating in from the B bomb site, and there it is. Hiko's found a gap, but he can't get any frags of it. Shox not going to get taken down, and now they know where JDM is as well. Indeed, Shox will get the bomb down, and now he goes trapped between two sides. Shox and Body. Body on the AWP. Hiko finally taking Shox down. Now he knows. Now he needs to wonder as to where Body is. He's got time, 30 seconds, to try and get things done here. That is a perfectly timed smoke as well. Found right place, right time, but is Body willing to go through the smoke, or will he just respect the situation and wait for the bomb plant?
Hiko is starting to get a little bit rushed. He's throwing a smoke down for cover, which is quite smart. Good forward thinking there. As he knows, Body's going to push forwards as soon as he starts the beeps, punches in the numbers, and the bomb will be planted. As now Body is in an unknown position as far as Hiko is concerned. He's got some good guesses, but there's only so much time here for Body to make the move. Hiko sort of stuck. This is an awkward position to be in. Already with the first two kills, Hiko looking for one of those classic Hiko clutches. Just one more player to go through to do so. As Body gets close now, Hiko hears him. He feels his presence, but where is he? There he is, turning the corner. Hiko able to escape, wasting time, and the kill will not go in favor of Hiko. But has he done enough? It's going to be really close right now. The defuse comes in for Body. Oh, just misses it there. Hiko gets the 1v3 clutch. That was so close. So close. 8-5 now, thanks to Hiko. To Liquid.
That is the closest denial I have seen recently. Very unfortunate for G2 indeed. So Liquid march on, and that is really bad for the economy of G2 as we go into the last two rounds of the first half. They've basically got no money here. And Scream, at the very least, is going to go for a force buy. He's gone for a 5-7 Kevlar and a flashbang, and he's got $50 in the bank, whereas I don't think his teammates have spent that much. Numbers game, safety in numbers. Four people going towards the plateau here for the CTs. Are they willing to push the smoke though?
Looks like they might be willing to do so. They got some flashes here. They go straight through the smoke to the end of the plateau. Going for the divers at least. The spray comes in. He's got teammates though to help him out to get the trade, but they're actually a little bit stuck right now. They haven't gained much ground, but with some of those shots, they are going to get just that. Shox, though, he's still close with the deagle, still causing problems as Shox picks up another frag there. Looking to find some heads. It's very dangerous right now for both Nitro and Hiko. Hiko goes down because Smith comes in from the flank, and all of a sudden, Nitro is in a 1v2. Shox has picked up an AWP, and that will sign the death warrant as Nitro will end up falling to that one. And we get another round there for G2, another unlikely round, but they can always pull these out of the bag.
Last round of the first half. And G2 in a situation where they can make things close. I would ask you how many rounds you think both teams need on their respective sides, but really with Liquid we have no idea what's going on, which is a great thing. I like that that kind of wildcard anomaly style of the Liquid team at the moment. Going into the last round, we have double orbs on the CT side this time, and no orbs for Liquid. So their fortunes have definitely taken a turn for the worse in this situation. So again, we've got harassment over towards the B-box site, but nobody committing to it just yet. We have Liquid lining up to maybe go for a push through the B-bomb site. And hopefully this time they can get the nades to go over the wall. It's not the highest wall then.
It's all quiet all of a sudden. G2 wondering, are they going to commit here? Another smoke thrown in. Oh, there's a gap! And Body's going to take full advantage, takes down EliGE, and that is not what Liquid wanted. Losing one of their riflers straight away, right before the push comes in, is a bad time. And now RpK is going to be looking for the defense here. He goes down, and, well, Liquid strike back here. That's what they needed, but Scream's still alive. Still with the, oh, not for long. Simple strike swiftly there as Scream hits the ground. And one after another, G2 are left in rubble.
Smith's all that's left here. Again, this is the last round of the first half, so he has to go for it. Unable to get anything done there. So it's going to be 9-6 going into the second half in favor of Team Liquid. So JDM maybe just adjusting something there. But that's a really good half from Liquid.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it's definitely quite needed because G2's T-sides are definitely quite well known to be a bit savage. So picking up six rounds already, I think G2 are going to feel pretty comfortable with that, as long as they can get off to a good start with this with the pistol round victory. We'll have to see how that one goes for them. But even if they lose it, I mean, again, it's G2. They can always surprise you. So, I mean, we've already seen some good performances from Shox and Scream. I mean, they're just going to be getting warmed up here. I mean, it is the first map for them of the finals here at the of ECS at the SSE Arena at Wembley. So I'm sure there's lots of work to come, lots of great shots to be seen already. And we had some really cool rounds. I think one of my highlights was probably the round where Body and Shox killed four people immediately with a deagle. That was pretty nice.
Yeah, that's a pretty good round. Now, we mentioned Simple JDM. I don't know if we mentioned Peacemaker as well, who is a coach. And I think he might be in-game leader for Liquid as well. So perhaps Simple is picking up roles that will be meant for Pimp when he finally comes in. Is Pimp playing the Major with them?
I'm not sure.
I think he might be. I think he might be playing with the Major with them, actually. But yeah, I'm fairly sure he is. Anyway, so the G2, three rounds down, the pistol will be crucial, as it almost always is. Yeah, NIP won both pistols in the previous map, so that definitely has a significant impact on how on the score, basically.
Yeah, especially that match was a good example. You win two pistols, but if you get crushed, it can still look close because they got pretty crushed. I'm really curious to see, you know, to hear their thoughts on that one a little bit later. I might try to pry some information and see what I can find out. But, you know, for now, I mean, the cool thing about this is that there's lots of potential for like fun stuff with Liquid, because they've got obviously an immense amount of individual skill. Nitro was having a pretty good game, to be honest. Earlier, we saw that on the T side, getting some, you know, really critical entry frags. Simple's obviously just Simple. It's always going to be, almost always going to be very good. And they can definitely try to run a double up setup at some point on this map if they want to. There's no reason why you can't have one on A, one on B. Or even 2 on A, let's do it. Well, maybe not 2 on A, but you know, you can get creative, and especially with the likes of JDM and Simple, you can always do that. And the cool thing about JDM, which I really like, is JDM is a player that he gets a lot better under pressure. He's really good at delivering under pressure. We saw that at E-League. The main storyline for his team was basically his performance when he was with CLG there, and he delivered. There was so much focus on him. National television, big crowd, lots of focus, and he delivers. That's the kind of player that he is. So Liquid's future with JDM, I think, is incredibly exciting.
Oh, I would definitely agree with you there. So the CT's putting the numbers over towards B. And G2 taking it slow. Just waiting to see if there are any shenanigans here by Liquid. There was I forget what team it was. It kept rushing on their CT side when we were at E-League in week one. Maybe it was CLG. I don't really recall. But anyway, no such play in this particular pistol round. Liquid just sat patiently waiting, looking to exploit the range of those USPs. He go down to on the 5-7 actually. So that's always interesting. When you're in a position which you think can be commonly rushed on a pistol round, it's always good to have a 5-7. And he is playing the drop zone, basically. So that is where you'd want a 5-7. I think it was Pimp who we saw, funnily enough, using dual Berettas, which it was either Pimp or Cadian, maybe both, who are using dual Berettas, which are obviously high in bullets as well. But it sucks. Doesn't have amazing accuracy. And here we go. So they're charging in Hiko's direction. He's got those 20 bullets in the magazine. Can he put them to work? He is the master beta, Dan, and he's got himself two kills. Body last man standing with the bomb as well. Can't expect him to get much done here. He got a P250. Almost getting knifed there. JDM will spare him the embarrassment. 10 rounds, double figures here for Liquid.
All right then, flawless pistol round, that's always going to be nice. Not only because it's a flawless pistol round and the opponents are denied money, but because they keep their Kevlar on almost all their players. They bought Kevlar on everyone but Hiko, so that is a nice little saving to make moving forwards. And they've got strictly SMGs here, and with no bomb plant, they should realize as well that G2 are playing with Tech-9s and that there could be, you know, kind of a smoke set piece here coming into some site. And it is the classic drop play. It's fast, but will it be ruthless and efficient? We've got Hiko there. Great off angle there with one kill. Not getting the second, though, but the bomb has been dropped. It's now been discovered by the CTs, and they converge on its position. And it is not pretty here for the CT side. They're going to lose two players already. Can G2 do anything more? Looks like they're going to be slowly but surely denied in the end, as everyone is eliminated. So that's actually going to work out really well that they had full SMGs moving into this round. That was a really fast rush there.
Fast rush is a good rush.
Yeah.
Five rounds between these two sides, and G2 don't have their money in the right place just yet. So that is a problem, because 12 rounds is reasonably close. If they can get there, which is looking very likely indeed, considering the non-buy here from G2. So the question now becomes, can G2 get a bomb plant in this particular round? Maybe not with Simple harassing them towards the lower area over there, towards A. And you can see JDM's taken an advanced position as well towards B plateau with support from EliGE. So the CTs will know to keep at least two people over towards A. But they have to be wary of the drop area as well. And indeed, you see players moving into there. So Hiko's going to have a Butchers. EliGE coming in as well. That is a very nice Bermuda Triangle there. Everybody disappearing from the radar for G2. Now, it's just going to leave Scream with a Glock. So best of luck to you, Kinds. One of the earlier skins in the game, actually. The Dragon Tattoo. I still have mine.
That's it. Went pretty well here overall. For Liquid, losing only one man. Going to make a lot of money, especially getting the kills on the SMGs. And so you can see their money's actually really sick. And that's going to help out massively too. You know, previously I was talking about double up potential. That's absolutely something they can go to. Now they have that option if they want, due to the security that they're going to get from the bank that they have created. But I think that, well, they're going to start off small here. Simple's going to keep himself on the MP7 there. And we have the UMP7 play on Nitro, so they're playing a little bit greedy then. It's definitely within the acceptable margins, and JDM's going to have the orb. And we might see a very fast play again from G2. They're going to be marching straight towards the plateau.
Yeah, we've got four CTs here, though, so if they continue their way, then they might be in for a lot of trouble here. EliGE with a two-man spray down, JDM coming in for support as well. That's going to leave shox alone. This is disaster for G2 here. Liquid on 13 rounds, looking very good. All good in the hood, Dan.
Yep, super clean, and one of the criticisms, one of the main criticisms of G2 is going to be that the structure that they have is quite simple, and it relies upon individual excellence as opposed to, you know, having, you know, really deep strategies and a deep level of tactics and stuff. They kind of got rid of that approach when they kicked Existence, because that's kind of what Existence is about. So, you know, you can see Liquid there, very well set up, easily able to deal with it. And right now, G2 aren't going to have many. Well, they're going to have one more good opportunity to save themselves in this best of one. Well, it's up to this how this eco goes. You can always see crazy stuff from them, but it's very unlikely that they'll pick this one up. We'll have to see. There's two players you can see. Nitro will get the first bit of information. Simple's boosted up towards A long as well. So a good setup here for Liquid.
Yeah, Simple's the man they can afford to lose. He's in a risky situation, but a nice read on Smith's approach there. Long range spray down coming in from Nitro. And Simple will look to clean up. There we go, nice deagle there by Shox, but that could be a consolation at this point. Three more players to find. That gives him potential, actually. He's got the bomb, and he's got a deagle. And now he's dead. So 14-6. It's been a while since G2 won a round. And again, the margin, well, the problem is, Dan, it's Liquid on 14 rounds. Yeah. They may get no more rounds.
Well, it's Liquid, though. They have JDM and Simple. Does that change things? I don't know. I think it might a little bit. I mean, I'm hoping so, at least, because I mean, it's never fun to see a team, you know, choking. That's not what we want to see. Absolutely not what they want to see. I mean, JDM knows how to close out games. Simple. Oh, we got the boost coming in. Shot missed, though, from JDM. That's unfortunate for him. Had a nice little opportunity there. Fallen was hitting a lot of like crazy fast shots like that earlier today. And we only have one bit of presence here for the Liquid side, which is Simple towards the A side. He's already been spotted. He's been tagged as well. So right now, actually, his life has been made quite difficult. He needs some assistance. He has somebody rotating in slowly but surely, but he's going to be easily eliminated as they had a really good beat on where he was standing. And now Hiko's going to rotate, but he's sort of alone. He's going to have a bit of help here. So Liquid actually having some problems at the moment because they're not sure where G2 are going. And you can see they're really feeling the problems that you have as a CT side in Cobble when you're down a man.
So there's opportunity for G2, but limited opportunity and limited margin for error. Bomb headed over towards the A side at present. And it seems Liquid have taken the right gamble in that they have two people on the site. However, the numbers game for G2 is looking pretty good right now. So Liquid, I mean, Nitro's out there on his own at the moment, and there's a reasonable chance he's going to get traded here. So this could be a pretty bad round for Liquid. And he's going to move into a very interesting crossfire here. But that Molotov may force Hiko from his position if it moves down. You never know with these Molotovs. They can get a bit wild later on. Oh, Nitro going to get wrecked immediately. But again, Hiko is going to be baiting. Going for the two-man spray down there, but he's going to play it safely. 6 seconds left, and that bomb's not going down here. So they just need to survive. RpK is in no man's land as well. And he may want to die. Oh, very nice headshot there to avoid getting taken down. And he finds JDM as well at the very end. But there's loads of cash onto Liquid, and it's 15-6, so they will not be too concerned.
Yeah, you gotta love how Hiko played that situation too. You know, he waited for the bomb to go down and killed that guy, and he only damaged the other guy a little bit because he had the recoil. So he's like, you know, I'll give it a few bullets because I have the eliminate surprise still. Then he went into cover and he waited. He could have peaked at any point. A lot of players would. Oh, I've got two teammates coming in, it's gonna be fine. He waited for the flash, and that's such a key detail there. So nice stuff there from Hiko. Need to see more of that. Big setup here from Liquid with the double orbs. G2 applying a lot of pressure towards the B-bomb site. And Liquid in response throwing a lot of counter grenades at the moment. And we'll have a lot of damage onto these G2 players that, you know, slowly but surely being whittled down. Now, the push is going to come in soon, and it's all going to be on this one. As mentioned, it's already match point here for Liquid.
All right, so Hiko needs to hold down this drop zone area. There's a lot of people there. Nitro coming in for the two-man spray down to make it three in that whole area. And that is a complete wipeout of G2. A very strong showing there by Liquid. A very strong showing indeed. Liquid with JDM instead of Kusta and Simple in a cameo appearance. Very nicely done by Liquid.
Yeah, I mean, throughout the entire map, they looked like the better team. It was just you know, a couple rounds where G2 were able to hit some crazy shots where they were able to pick up the victory in some of those rounds. And other than that, it was Liquid always finding consistency, they, you know, applying structure, you know, some good team play. And again, if you consider the fact that they've just got two new players, that's a really big deal that they managed to do that in such short time. And there has been a lot of word that in practice they've been really strong lately. And another thing to think about is that JDM is one of the hardest working players probably in the North American scene. The guy works his ass off when it comes to preparation. So that serious attitude, that's something that, you know, a player like Hiko absolutely loves, because Hiko just wants to win. And if you get a player like JW with you, when you're a guy like Hiko, that's amazing.
Yeah, he works his ass off, I want to say.
Sorry.
Despite leaving the European Union, we're definitely still English.
I'm still jet lagged, still feeling a bit of America.
Fair enough. Well, I mean, that's a bit of a shock to G2, but maybe they didn't know what to expect from a Liquid with a number of wild cards, if you will. But again, a very strong performance from Liquid, and they will need to perform strong because they will be going up against Luminosity in the next part of the Group A bracket. So an early loss for G2 is not what they will have been looking for. And obviously, you know, with this new lineup, they had a very strong start indeed, beasting a bunch of teams and playing at very high levels. But now they're starting to, maybe things are calming down to a more normal level where they will win some and lose some, etc. So we'll see what they do going forward. It's nice to see Shox and Scream showing up at least to some degree there. Those are the booths on the stage, by the way, that have been built for the ECS finals. Haven't been in there myself just yet, but maybe we can have a visit in them later.
Yeah, and the point you're making about the Shox and Scream as well, it's just, obviously there's like that month period where they're just going incredibly ham, just insane performances. But that, it also shows you that's the limitation of the team, and there is always going to be inherent inconsistency if you just have to rely on performance of individual players' execution mechanically. That, I mean, hell, in the game itself, there's a degree of inconsistency there. You don't have the first bullet accuracy. It's not there on the AK-47. It's not always going to be accurate on the first bullet. Every gun in the game is to an extent like that, right?
So there's no perfectly accurate gun.
There it is. So you know, if you're gonna have a style of play where you hedge all your bets in your individual skill, you tone down strategy and so on, you're gonna have some consistency issues.
All right, let's see what a desk thinks. Scoots, take it away.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Well, see, Fifi, you should have stuck with your gut. You should have stuck with North America.
It's really hard to, you know, like, stick with your guns when you have a angry Serbian right next to you.
I'm not angry.
Like, do you really want to do that? Yeah. I was like, oh.
Yeah, maybe not. G2, yeah. But yeah, great. Both halves great by Liquid, 9-6, and then obviously they win it out. What went wrong for G2, or what went right for Liquid?
I feel, yeah, exactly. I think it's a combination of two things, that Liquid played extremely well, but also G2 wasn't up to their usual standards, right? And I was surprised initially. I wasn't expecting Liquid to have as much structure, so to speak, in their play. Yes, they had some of the fast threats, but they also showed that they can take a step back, play it slowly, get some map control, even execute some of the fakes. So in this game, they completely outplayed G2, especially in the first half. The only round G2 won were the rounds after the pistol round.
Yeah.
Then they won the two ecos and the 4v2, basically, and that's it.
And I think that's something we forgot to touch upon coming into this game. They have a new coach.
True, yeah, true.
Right? They have Peacemaker, obviously former Tempo Storm, now Immortals ex-coach, and I think he's done a lot for this team. You saw that in E-League, there was a bit of discussion of, well, how much has he actually done with this team? But I think now with the addition of the two new players, they actually sat down, they got some, that's why you probably see, you still have the tendency of just like, okay, well, just brute force our ways into the bomb site. But you also have the tendency of, it's like, well, we have set strats now as well, and let's say execute on them just in case we want to.
Yeah, there was a round in particular that Liquid executed. It was a fake towards the B bomb site that was really well executed, and you could clearly see that the plan that they had behind it when they were executing. We actually have a replay
perfect
of it, and we can now see how it worked perfectly for them in that round. These are the NIP smokes, so to speak, that go towards the B bombs, and even if they missed them a little bit, you can see two players are actually fully committed to this fake. Body overpicks a little bit, and you can see how Hiko is on that lurking role, knowing that there's going to be a player rotating. That's RpK in that case, and they get the kill on him as well. Smith is alone on the A bomb site after that, and he's basically being pinched from both mid and connector, and it was a pretty straightforward round for Liquid, and you can see how it can work really well if it's executed properly.
So for those folks at home, obviously that is going to mean that NiP is going to play G2 now. So just a couple little thoughts on that before we move forward.
I think that's going to be a good matchup. These teams just played each other in E-League recently. G2 won the first during the bracket stage. G2 ended up beating NIP, but then obviously NIP won that best of three in the grand final on that live show. So I think that these two teams, they have a massive history, shox and smiths and obviously NIP boys. So I think that's that game's going to be very interesting tomorrow.
And of course, on the other side of the coin, that means LG Liquid rematch. Again, slightly different roster with JDM now, but obviously that was the killer of the major, where Liquid basically gave it away a lot. And they've done it a couple times since.
Definitely. Yeah, I don't think we're going to see the same Liquid here. I think that, I mean, sure, we granted this was the first game we've ever seen them in. We have no idea how they end up. Let's say that they are going to play Luminosity now. Let's say they do end up in the lead. 1-2 rounds away, and then you see the same tendency. I hope that's not the case. Overall, I think the Liquid looks a lot better now. We only saw one game from them so far, but just the general structure, and it feels like the all the players actually have like a somewhat of a set role now, which I didn't really feel like they had before when they had Kusta, for example, and then you were stuck with this like, well, we have two main uppers, like what's gonna happen here, and then it was just half-assed.
I also think it's important to note that on a map like Cobble, there's not much CTs can do to dictate the pace of the game or how the round is going to go. It's basically up to the Ts, and then the CTs can react, and they can't react in a lot of ways. That's one of the flaws with Cobblestone. There's not much that the CTs can do in terms of map control or aggression. Yeah. So that's perfect for Liquid as a new team and a team that no one knows at this point. So they can dictate the pace of the game. They can do what they're comfortable with, and it forces G2 to react. And it's much harder for them to get a read on this Liquid because they've switched two players, basically.
And again, our Jason Bourne man of the match is going to be Hiko. It was probably the eighth round, right, where he does this crazy clutch. Again, the movie's in stores, I almost said. Yeah. Movie theaters, July 29th. Can't wait.
There were a couple of these close rounds, but it didn't even matter in the end. Even if Liquid loses those rounds, they win the game in the end. I was worried when they got to 14-6. Yeah. Like, okay, this is where the game actually starts.
Exactly.
Is Liquid going to be able to close it out? And then there's that, again, it was Hiko, the player that was crucial in that round, hiding in the A bomb site and then killing the bomb planter, leaving G2 with not enough time to win the round.
Final thoughts on the matches. We're waiting for Smix to get ready with the interview.
I think that if G2 plays like this tomorrow, they're going to have a bad time. I think that actually might end up getting eliminated here by NIP. And I think for Liquid, Luminosity has been over here in Europe boot camping, and Luminosity has just been basically on a break. So it's going to be very exciting to see here. If Liquid keeps on playing the same way they did versus G2 here, I think that we might actually have a pretty decent game in our hands.
Yeah, I agree. Liquid historically always had close games with LG, even when they had maybe weaker lineups on paper. And seeing as it is a best of one, it's a perfect opportunity for Liquid to upset LG and make it to the semis.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen. That's going to do it for our segment. We're not done talking about the match, though. Smix has the new guy on the Liquid roster coming from CLG. Smix, take it away with JDM.
That is correct, Scott. I am here with JDM after a very solid-looking win for you guys against G2. First of all, prior to the game, did you expect it to go so smoothly, and was there any sort of prep done?
We boot camped for the last, like, 2 weeks or a week and a half, so it's a really short period for, like, a new team, a new roster, and especially for me. We had to change a little bit, a couple of things, but, I mean, so far, like, we went into this tournament, like, we felt comfortable and we felt confident because the scrims and everything that we did in boot camp, like, went really well, so.
So you just mentioned that you guys had to change up a few things. Can you elaborate a little bit on that and just what that transition has been like overall, since especially for you, you're entering a new team, you have a new coach, and so obviously there's a lot of things that are up in the air.
Yeah. Well, for me, it's like I'm, like, as an operator, I float around the map. CT side and T side, so that's kind of something we changed a little bit. Other than that, I mean, Lewis, our coach, Peacemaker, we had to change a lot from that because he's now calling for us. So it's pretty much going over strats. We had to go over a lot of stuff for each map, smokes, flashes, just a lot of executes and everything. So that took a while, but yeah.
Well, we just saw it went smoothly with G2. Up next, you will be playing Luminosity, which is obviously the number one team in the world. Definitely going to be kind of tough. But prior to that match, what is the team huddle going to look like?
It's just the same thing. I mean, we're confident going into every match. But, you know, Luminosity, they're insane. So we just got to be in the top of our game and stay calm and just play our own game.
Yeah. Now, my last question for you before I do let you go. I know that this is still a new team, new sort of everything going on with Peacemaker and all that, but still, every team likes to come into a tournament wanting to win. Realistically speaking, knowing where your team is at personally yourself, how do you feel that Liquid is going to do here?
Honestly, this is the first time like I've actually come into a tournament where I felt like I was going to win the tournament.
Wow.
So I just think we have so much firepower on this team. I hope that doesn't like backlash on me, but I just feel comfortable like and confident with this team. Everyone is just like insane aim and can make a play and just can go off. And it's just about staying calm and just being relaxed and playing our own game. So.
Well, relaxed coming from the lounge in JD himself, but very interesting, confident words coming from JD, which will be really cool because we do have Luminosity versus Liquid coming up next. So we'll see how JDM's confident words come out to play in that match. So stay tuned. That comes up after this break.
Do you play Counter-Strike?